Thank you for joining us. I have the pleasure of being joined today by Steve Birkhold. Steve was the former CEO of Lacoste, of Diesel, and BEBE. Let's actually focus on California for a moment. What trends are you seeing in California that you're not seeing, I would say, in the rest of the country?
Well, you know, people think California is this crazy, unique marketplace. I lived here for a couple of years, and it's definitely different than the highly densely populated Northeast that's more of an urban type of market. What I think is unique about California is how spread out the major metropolitan areas are, whether it be San Diego, Los Angeles, San Jose, San Francisco, all those parts of California. I think that where you don't have the densification from an urban perspective, the landlords, the malls, the shopping centers need to really undergo a really in-depth merchandising strategy to make sure that they attract the right customer. And I think that's really where I start to see, whether it be the BEBE centers or all the other major centers, South Coast Plaza, all the other major centers in California, I really see those landlords really spending a lot of time now on making sure that they really have a strong merchandising strategy, they know who their consumers are, and then they do a lot of local marketing in order to attract that. So the combination of retail, all the entertainment assets of restaurants, movie theaters, et cetera, I think is a little more unique in California, this kind of lifestyle center, and giving people other reasons to go shop versus just, you know, a destination. Because I really think there's very few stores today that really, if you look at it objectively, are considered destinations that people go to one mall to go see. So the mall has to become more appealing as a general shopping destination versus an individual retailer.
So I'm seeing in my practice a lot more of my fashion clients really focusing on outlets than I've ever seen before. I think the statistics are there are six times more outlets being opened for my brands than regular retail. Are you seeing this trend?
Well, yeah, I mean, it's, you know, listen, we always looked at outlets as another channel of distribution. Originally, outlets we saw not as, you know, selling secondary products in, like, you know, places that were 60, 70 miles away from an urban population center. We actually saw them as kind of, you know, where the local population shops. So, and again, you go back to a merchandising strategy, when you look at it that way, you know, you can't just ship in your excess. You've got to give them, again, if you're BEBE and you're selling dresses, but she also wants to buy a jean or a t-shirt and a pair of shoes, et cetera, you have to make sure that your outlet offering, whether it's MFO, which is made for outlets specifically, or excess product, you've got to make sure that the store is very well merchandised. So I would say probably the evolution of outlets has gone from just being a destination to liquidate mistakes to really a shopping destination where is a primary shopping destination for a lot of people in the local markets. And I think as you see outlets encroaching on more urban areas, they have to do the same thing, right? So living in New York City, you know, Woodbury Commons is like 55 miles outside of New York City. So I think the proposition that they have there with, you know, remodeling the center, you know, bringing in Shake Shack and, you know, doing all the same elements that any shopping area is kind of doing today is really what's happening. And I think, you know, they can very easily coexist, and most CEOs of most companies are happy to do as much outlet business as full-price business because the margins on the made-for-outlet products are generally even higher than the full-price products.
Yeah, and what's interesting is the plaintiffs bar have gone after many of the outlet players, arguing that because products are sold in the outlet that weren't sold in retail, you're seeing a lot of class action lawsuits now saying that there's been a fraud on the public. And so we're as we look at new ways of conducting business, the plaintiff's bar has figured out ways to bring more lawsuits, which is kind of interesting to keep up with the trends.
Well, I mean, that's one unique thing about California. There's more class action going on here than anywhere else in the country. So whether it be those kind of lawsuits, I mean, at any given time, at any company, Lacoste, Diesel, BEBE, we had dozens of, you know, lawsuits for a lot of different reasons. So, and you know, the attorney generals are very specific in states on price comparison and all that. So most brands are pretty sophisticated in understanding those, and they work with their key legal providers to make sure that they don't violate any of those local ordinances.
Well, I want to thank you, Steve, for taking the time to join us. Appreciate the advice.
Great. Thank you, Tony.